Great. Well done for today. New learning on Upper Intermediate Group. We're learning some really good expressions. The key here is that they are fixed expressions. You can't change them in any way. Let's go through the meaning of some of these things. All of them, each and every shows habit. So we say, each and every week I teach English. I wouldn't say that because I teach English much more than just once a week. You could say each and every month, each and every year, I do something. Shows habit, shows I do it every week or every month or every year without fail. It's very strong. All these expressions are stronger than just every week. Each and every week, it's strong. Shock and horror means shock, but we add and horror to make it more extreme. To his shock and horror, this happened, this terrible thing happened. Life is full of ups and downs, isn't it? Life is full of good stuff and bad stuff. Also, life is full of pros and cons, positives and negatives. There are pros and cons to all situations. You have to really weigh up the pros and cons. Sooner or later, in the end, this will happen, you know. But when's it going to happen? Well, sooner or later, you just need to wait and see, be patient and find out later. Ifs and buts, we tend to use this in the negative. I want you to do this. Oh, but I can't. No ifs or buts. I want you to do it. No excuses, please. Ins and outs is all about the exact details. Could you explain to me the ins and outs of present perfect? Not now, I'm very busy. It's about asking for exact details of something. Give and take, this is all about relationship. In relationship, there needs to be compromise and flexibility. You need to give and take in relationship. By and large is another way of saying generally speaking. We've learned lots of different ways over the terms of saying in general, generally, basically. Here's another way of doing it. By and large. By and large, English people are lovely. Okay, maybe I shouldn't say that. By and large, English weather is great. In general.
Yeah, right.
Grin and bear it. You know, if you don't like something, sometimes you just have to grin and bear it. You just need to tolerate it. Odds and ends, oh, we use this a lot. Things. What did you buy at the shop? Well, just a few odds and ends, you know, a bit of this, a bit of that. Things, just generally. Take it or leave it. Now, this has got a great little expression at the end. Look, I will sell you this for 80 quid. Take it or leave it. Beans basically means you can accept it or refuse it, but I don't care anymore, I'm fed up. It's basically when you're negotiating. You know, how much is this? £100. It's a bit expensive. Look, well, how about 90? Look, I've sent you for 80 quid, take it or leave it. You know, you're fed up. No more bargaining, no more haggling. That's it. Accept it, reject it. I don't care anymore. Just whatever. Here are some of the ones you put together afterwards. Now and then means sometimes or occasionally. Well, how often do you go on holiday? Now and then. Not too often, but yeah, occasionally. I'm sick and tired of the English weather, yes? No, you're not. Great, I'm glad to hear it. If you've had enough of something and you can no longer take it, you say, I'm sick and tired of it. More or less means approximately. Have you done your homework? Well, more or less. Yes?
Yes.
Good. Don't say more or less, say yes. Means, if I say, have you done your homework, and you say, well, more or less, it means you haven't really done it yet. You've sort of done it, you've got maybe you need to complete it. It's not 100% complete yet. Touch and go, uncertain that you will complete or succeed in something, and it's very like edgy. This is a very edgy expression. You know, I was in that aeroplane and it was really touch and go whether or not we would make it. You know, we could have crashed, we could have made it, and luckily we made it. Peace and quiet, you get home from work. Kids are shouting, feed them, get them to bed, sit in front of the TV or something like that, or just have some peace and quiet silence. Maybe no TV then, okay? Safe and sound, all is well. Normally, you know, if my mum used to do this a lot. My auntie used to come round and have evening meals with us all often. And my auntie would go home, and she only lived 5 minutes away. But then my auntie would need to phone my mum to say, it's okay, I've got home safe and sound. All is well, no problems. slowly but surely. This is talking about something that's in progress or improving slowly, and it will get done in the end. You know, how's that report coming? Well, slowly but surely. Okay, so it's in progress, you know it's going. And finally, there and then means immediately. I want you to do it there and then means I want you to do it immediately. That's a lot of expressions for one lesson. Learn them all. There'll be a test next week. Thank you.